you know, I don't want to instill in a jail, you know. But there is sort of a what appears to be a little bit of a release that I think is probably nice and helpful.
Thank you all again for some deep answers. So here's one of these questions that is really, I mean, there's really no right answer. And that's with everything as we're talking about it. These are all issues in process. But here, so often the jail system or the people who run the jails and prisons, one of the ways in which they've taken to pushing new jails and expansion is by saying, well, we have to improve conditions, as if they are on the side of improving things. And, you know, that we either have to have special pods for trans and gender nonconforming people, and so let's build new beds, or we need better mental health services, so let's build a whole new behavioral health justice center, which in fact is locked and so therefore is a jail. And yet, of course, people inside want better conditions. So how do we navigate that? How do we try and, you know, advocate for some improvements for real issues that people are facing, and at the same time not make building more and better jails the solution? So I'll mix it up some more and start with Julia.
To talk about the conditions inside, I remember doing this Bill of Rights on the inside, and I can remember the smell of feces, like so strong, like that. I remember doing the group kind of like this, and then what do you think about this? Like literally, we were doing it like that, and people. I remember people coming in with paint all over them. The people that are inside of there, inside of the groups, and then them having the paint because they were doing the painting. They were doing the painting and everything. There was like no mask or anything. They were just in their regular state issued clothing, painting, and trying to clean it up because they knew that they had to live inside of there. And they were just doing the work just to be able to do something, you know, do something on the inside. But just to talk about like how really just not the conditions on the inside are just, and that was a lot of things that like drove inside of here too. It's just like even the right just to have a fresh pair of clothes. I mean, just a fresh, decent smelling pair of clothes. So and I think that I'll have to read the question again too. In order to even get there and get like mentally be able to get there, like if you're being treated like this animal, you know, it's just really hard to, it's just really hard to even be able to do the organizing and everything. So thank you for saying about just sometimes just talking with people and just having a conversation about just whatever kind of is happening, you know, being able to listen. The question was about methods and strategies. Do you think work best?
No, I mean, they're all connected. This is more, you said, given all those things you just said,
yeah.
Then how do you not advocate for just...
Oh, closing it down?
Yeah, or a better jail, because they're going to say, oh, well, if we built another jail, mm-hmm. you wouldn't smell feces when you come in here. It would be all clean and new.
Mm-hmm. That is something when we were on the outside and we were fighting for that, when they had to, like, they snuck in this meeting trying to get this new jail built, and we had to, like, we took over the meeting and everything, and we participated in it, and that was a real thing, that we really still have loved ones on the inside, and so that was something that we did have to talk about, too, because, like, I envision not having to ever have to do something on the inside. I envision this place as not even being a solution for anybody. Like, I make that very clear that I hope that these places shut down and I'll be able to do something like more organizing on the outside. Like, that is my dream, to be able to do that. But the reality is we still have people on the inside right now, so it's just difficult. But we have to, I think, still be holding that longer term vision of that we don't want this. We don't want this facility. And then also still doing stuff on the inside too, and hearing, because people still say, I need this. Like, I need access to this thing inside of here in order for me to make it be while we're doing our work. So I think that that's why it's important too for everybody's role inside of the group. Any of the work that we're doing inside or outside, it's all really important, sacred work that we're doing to bring up people, free our people.
Let's go to Alicia and then circle around. When sitting here, I just have to truthfully be honest with myself, and it's like, and when I think of my honesty, I think of the realism of what will life be like without any type of, you know, jail or something like that. So I think that when in terms of speaking of something like this, you have to come up with alternatives already. If you want something like this to stop, you have to already have what you want in place of it. Otherwise, you're, what else? Because they say, okay, we're going to shut the jail. What do you have open to do? Because, you know, being in jail, I've seen some crazy stuff. Like, excuse my, but seriously. So it's like, I will not excuse the fact that life happens and we commit crimes. I commit crimes. I did. I don't want to be dehumanized as a part of it, but it's like, Where do these people go after the jail has been shut down? Because something still has to be done about it. So I think that's a plan that you could always think of, as far as like when moving forward, asking, can we close this down? It's like, okay, well, this is where we gonna put. What, this is how we gonna do this. And it's like, either way go, if you know, I don't want to blow smoke up your ass. Be like, oh, we'll set up this state of the art facility. There is no such thing as a better jail or a good jail or whatever that is. You know, I don't know a jail that's good, you know. And it's like, sometimes we're jailed inside of our minds, and it's like, you can't move that. You have to be able to move past it. So I don't really know how to go about that. My thing was, when we were asked these questions, is that how do, like, water. We drink water from like this out the sinks, and that's connected to a toilet. How can we get better water? How can we get fresh air implemented into these facilities? Because it's nothing but a bunch of recycled air. Women sit on these concrete slabs and fucking metal slabs with thin mattresses, and our bodies are messed up. We ache and stuff, at like, you can't roll over and stuff like that. So even if you're not tearing this down in the process, how can you make this a more breathable situation? It don't even have to be livable, because I don't want to live here. How can I just be, at least when I go home from prisons and jails, I'm unhealthy. Either I didn't eat the food or I ate too much of it. Because I just nasty, or it's because I just don't have nothing else to eat and everything else is so high. When they say, oh yeah, we're gonna improve this by giving them soap, it went from this big to this big now, thank you. And it's still paper thin, and there's no nothing else to symbolize the fact that I'm a human. It's no, it's just all natural odors, and you're just dealing with that every day. So it's like, you know, it's cool to have groups and all of that stuff. But when I think of when I was sitting in jail and what I wanted to happen for me, it was like, I just want this to be over. And then when I got out, it was like, I was more so concerned with, where am I going to go when I get out? Because that's what made me go back. I didn't have nowhere to go when I got out. Mm-hmm. I went to all of the programs and got all of the certificates and did all of the completions and still didn't have a damn job when it was over with. And they was like, oh, this cycle, when it comes up, you're the first on the list. I'm still on the waiting list. Mm-hmm. You know? So it's like, I don't know. I would suggest that, you know, you come up with an alternative to where, how this will work without this. Like, you have to imagine the life in the communities you live in without jails, and how could you go about ensuring the safety of the people and everything else that goes with that.
Okay, let's see. What?
You don't like my order flipping around, but okay.
with you. All right, it's hard. The conditions thing is really challenging, because it is people are really, really suffering, and you know, there are people who are coming apart while they're inside. So I think that how I can give some examples of how we've reconciled or struggled with or grappled with the tension of conditions and not wanting to increase money or resources or even power going towards the jail or prison system. And so I definitely agree with what Alicia was saying around having resources going towards what you want instead, just to state that part. So like thinking about like, how do we think about reentry? How do we think about alternatives? Sometimes that can answer that question, right? So like sometimes if like Diana was saying earlier, if the city is proposing opening a behavioral health justice center, then you say, so why did you close down the beds at San Francisco General? Why is it that you have to be inside of a cage in order to get adequate mental health care? Why is what you want to build a locked facility, but anytime we're like, why don't you do scattered site, like mental health services, and people just walk in if they even feel like they're having a hard time, and they're like, no, like, how is that gonna work? And you're, you have money for a jail. What? Like, it doesn't make any sense. And so you see the logic that in terms of priorities means that people are going to inevitably end up in a jail as opposed to healthy in communities if you start from a cage mentality, right? Like, and so I think that in